Bag of things, they have to make a statement. If I know bag of things, TV, it don't make sense. A bag of things, TV, I run things all the time. Bag of things, they have to make a statement. If I know bag of things, TV, it don't make sense. A bag of things, TV, I run things all the time.
Yes, I, Elmatic, there's a represent for bag of things, TV media. You don't know, tune in, you hear a bag of things.
Bag of things, TV media.
Pleasant day, my beautiful viewers and subscribers. You see me, I say, when you know, say the big bad Bag of Things Media TV, you know, saying the original Bag of Things Media TV, I must say. So, right now, star me, I tell you, say, shotgun seized by cops on patrol in Gregory Park, St. Catherine, you know. Yeah, man, you know, I look on the screen right now, that big old lot of shotgun they want to see. The police, them take it off our road. So, we don't have nothing more to worry about. This is a wicked gun, you know. Yeah, man, them gun here shoot off some 12 gauge rounds. We shoot off all your head viewers and subscribers on a serious level. So the cops them finally seized the one here. You see me, I say? And here where police them, I say now. The police seized a firearm during a patrol in Gregory Park, Portmore, St. Catherine area on Friday, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go on here now. Reports are that the law enforcers saw two men boarding a motor car along the roadway. The men's action aroused the suspicion of the lawmen. The officer approached the men and one of the men run. You see, I say, boy, take myself, you know, quick and fast, you know. Because him thinks that the police, they might hear that you have some smart police in their force right now. From them, see some boy move jiggy and shaky. Yes, man, the boy, the police, they money near food. The police are going near me food. I want to say that boy, they're lucky. If I did have some trigger happy police in their force, you know. They near me food still, but at the same time, they hold on for the little nasty nigga boy. I'm bringing me in.
The police approached the men and one of them run. Three persons were held in the car in which a shotgun was found and seized. Investigation are ongoing in the development. Ladies and gentlemen, me I tell you, no. Boy, me I tell you, them boy, the boy, me I tell you, them the youth are lucky. Them the youth, if you just done and just done with the badness and give them life to God. Change over them life because suppose say the police them did open fire and I care and kill off all of them. That man asking them. Suppose the police did do that because the police them have all rights from them see boy with gun and bugger things.
Worse if them did all point the gun them after the police them and the policeman them know say boy them life is in danger. Dog niam them supper, you know. I lucky them lucky still, man. Nah, like. Right now, I want to talk about a serious case right now with Adams, Renito Adams. I mean, I tell you, for Adams, you know, this a situation, you know. Boy, the kind of dark still, but I just say thing go. Different police in a go on a Jamaica, you know, still. You understand? The next incident we'll talk about is Renito Adams. Renito Adams slam US and call the United States hypocritical. Yeah, man. I don't lie, man, I tell. The United States is a very hypocritical set of country, you know. Is that people them were very hypocritical. And you know how them steer. I agree with Mr. Adams. Them watch other people country, control other people country, seeing, and them don't watch freedom country. And you can't, remember, you know, God can't leave the United States and come to Haiti and go to Haiti and go to Jamaica and go to Dominican Republic and other countries. But no God can't come back in America, no time at all, seeing. So Mr. Adams, I call them hypocrite. The United States is a big hypocrite, you know, seeing. I mean, nah, lie about that a reality man a talk star. John, no. So, let me tell you what the big man has said now. Because I don't know Sir Adams, I'm a bridging now. Yeah, man, Mr. Adams, ready to Adams, I'm a bridging star. Because the man, they deal with the policing thing in Jamaica, serious, you know. It was a man that take him job serious, so I respect him. You know, big man has said now, hypocritical is how retired senior superintendent of police, Renito Adams, refers to the United States after learning that his State Department underscored a concern that some members of the Jamaica Constabulary Force, JCF, could be involved in human trafficking in its 2021 trafficking in persons report. At that aguan, so at them propaganda the United States has spread upon Jamaica, I said the JCF members, the police, them involved in a human trafficking. When I not go like it when Adams have said about them. Yeah, Mr. Adams has said no. In an interview with the Jamaica Observer, Adams expressed disappointment at the pronouncement which said human traffickers exploit domestic and foreign victims in Jamaica and victims from Jamaica abroad.
So Adams are bona fire upon them upon a serious level, you know, you know. See? The United States is a hypocrite. Mr. Adams has said that, you know. Everybody involved in corruption. And only Jamaican police alone. For them police too. Our police work in conjunction with them. One hand can't clap. Many of the countries in the Caribbean and Central America, their policemen are involved in a lot of things. Adams are bona fire back upon them, a warm to them. A style and one style Jamaica. You must say mad. One of the things that the big general Mr. Adams done with the boy them. You hear what Mr. Adams say again? They are trafficking the same. Trafficking drugs, human trafficking. And they know that too. I don't know why they want to call out Jamaica. You see me I say? Mr. Adams has said that to a boy them, big and serious. Cause I be a propaganda them a try to spread for Jamaica. Jamaican police them a fight human trafficking. I don't hear of nothing when man them involved in no bag of wrong thing, you know. And now bull all day and foolishness, you know. Seeing the American police them involved in a whole heap of extrajudicial killing. Look back. When we are talking about all them black men that we are getting shut up all the time in America. Oh, we not hear nobody talk about them thing then. See? So right about now, viewers and subscribers, I want you guys to comment below. Tell me what you feel about this. One of the things that Mr. Adams is in the right by styling up a couple of them boys the way I styled up Jamaica and I try this country and bugger things. Are one of the things that Mr. Adams not in the right to talk like that. I don't know. Please don't tell me what I go on. Comment below. You don't know more here when I say about this, you know. You know what I'm saying? Cause them things are some serious discussion we have to have right now on a serious level. So right now, the little youth them for their school and I learn a trade star. I can't understand this. They're saying that child hustlers on the increase. Little youth them wear washi car glass them and bag of things. Whole for hustling. The little youth them not supposed to hustle. The youth them in Jamaica with upon the street. The government have to find a better way for them. This story we're going to talk about now, this incident, is that there's a big increase in the child hustling thing, you know. Them little youth upon the street, you know, saying these little youth need to be taken off the streets and go get a trade. We need to give them job, help them. You hear what they must say in our paper now. Studies show that estimated 2,000 Jamaican children making a living on the streets, you know, seeing conflicting calls for prosecution of their parents. Some of them parents they must held accountable, you know. Me nah lie. Some of them parents have to get locked up too, you know. Because how come so much people upon the street are hustle? Why the parents ended up them in the first place? And that I question, you know, with the ox, you know. If you can't manage the picnic them, you can't afford them, stop off the picnic them. Why would not have a picnic them and I send them out on the road for go hustle and work? You wear paper sick, I don't believe it's a lie, me I tell. According to the just released and long-awaited study of child working on living on the streets in Jamaica, approximately 2,000 Jamaican children are hustling on the street, starting as young as age 5, usually with begging and windscreen or windshield wiping. You know. So first of all, they start off, yo big man, yo dads, yo my general, yo brother. Big your dollar, no, yo, big your money, no. Sometimes I see them start, I'm not like, I'm sorry for them, I have to send out a thing. What you mean? I have to send out a thing for the little youth, them one, but at the same time, look at money where we are giving them, can't help them fully. These kids need big help, they need some real serious help, you know. Send them a school, cause a young boy, them, give them a trade. And there's something me see I go on in IJCF which me respect them for right now. The JCF are now recruiting a lot of boys, kids in general, at the age of 16 and then give them subject, teach them maths, English and all type of stuff. I didn't get to do that story, but I wanted to do it a couple days ago. And then after now, these kids are going to be transitioned over to the JCF from cadet. So they will take them in as cadet, recruit them, train them and give them subjects, teach them maths, English and some other subject and transition them over to the JCF. So most of them youth up on the street now, I hope they can jump into the program there now. The cadet program. So right now they are recruiting. The JCF is recruiting cadets. The government must take off the little boy off the street and recruit them as police. You understand? Because we can't expect say boy they won't come out good if your parenting not good enough. If a yard mash up and nothing go on a yard, what you expect to go on? Be your foolishness. Take the youth them off the street. You see me I say? So right now, I'm showing you what I go on and now. With a good move I go on from one superstar in Jamaica when you and Blake, you know. The same little boy them we are talking about on the street when I have no parents. Guess what you and Blake are going on there now? Big up yourself, Mr. You and Blake still. I'm a boss. You and Blake, dormitory, football, turf, for boys' home, almost complete. When I look on the screen, good no man. You see that facility here? It is created by the big runner, superstar runner, when you and Blake, you know. We run alongside Usain Bolt. The man had built a place. A man built a place almost complete. Now the little youth them with up on the street, they're gonna be taken to this location and live like a superstar. Look upon the place, good. Football field there, pool, all type of dormitory, turf. The youth them are gonna live like superstar, you know. Cause remember, you know, you and Blake a big track and field superstar, you know, seeing. So he's using his money now to spend towards the little youth them on the street. Yeah, what they must say now. The 2011 world champion Juan Blake has announced that the new dormitory and football turf for the Mount Olivet boys' home in Walter, let me pronounce that good, Walderstone, Manchester, built by his YB Afraid Foundation, will soon be ready. So this will soon be ready. The little boy them soon get to take off a street and go live like stars.
Ja, that sounds good. Me feel good right now. Me just couldn't go so much bad news and not go to something good for no boy. Changes is coming to Jamaica. It might be long, but for not forever, you know. Hear what they must say.
The double Olympic silver medalist made an announcement on his Facebook page on Tuesday. Hear what they must say now. When you dream of something and it is finally come alive, my dream is to see every kid that is suffering, that is a ward of the state, live normal life. So ward of the state are kids that are up on the streets. The state involved for them. And the state have to take them off for the street and treat them better. No, Mr. Ewan Blake, now we have him bag of money, you know. Sit down on him bag of money and he plan to use it right. But respect him. Good youth. Bless up yourself, my youth. Saying, yeah, man. Yeah, what they must say now. Blake wrote that while sharing photograph of the new dormitory and football turf. So take your boy them off a street, help them,
provide for them, and create a better future for them so that them little youth don't become gunmen, you know. Because them bust gun and shoot up innocent people and get led easily by criminal elements, you know what I'm saying? But when you save them, you don't have that the problem to deal with. That is so simple, you know what I'm saying? So if people don't have a bag of dirty money, sit down on your yard, don't just sit down on the money, help you them and do what them for do. That's why I respect Bounty Killer too. Bounty Killer is a big man where look out for people, poor people, governor, same way. He's been contributing to people. He's been a philanthropist for the longest while. You know what I'm saying? So big up yourself, Warlord. You and Blake them, Usain Bolt them, so many people. Dana Gov, I think her name is Dana Gov. She's doing a lot too. You know what I mean? So many more. I can't even name them out, but to the big up on yourself. Bag of Things Media TV recognized on the same way. You think, big man? Up.
Bag of Things Media TV, man. Thank you for watching. Make sure you share it. Make sure you subscribe. Press that notification bell to stay updated, man. Jamaican assassin killing all names. Urban legend. Jackal out.